Hey there, this is Abdul, and today we are going to draw this vector art with a tablet and a pen. I'm going to describe all the process with steps one by one. Together with that, I'm going to tell you how you can arrange your layers. In the end, I have a surprise for you that will make making a portrait way easier than you think. Together with that, I'm going to tell you how you can arrange your layers one by one, and there would be four major steps that you have to follow to complete the portrait. There would be also a talk of colors, what colors you can use in your portrait. I'm also going to tell you how you can make a pressure sensitive brush that can work with your pen and tablet. And there is a lot more. So without any further delay, let's get going. Now, before we start, I would like to wear my glasses. First of all, I would like to make a brush that can work as a pressure sensitive brush, compatible for pen and tablet. For making a brush, follow me. Go to brush panel. If you don't see this, then go to Windows, search for brushes, and here you get it, brushes icon, and then click this plus icon to make a new brush. And here you choose calligraphic brush, hit OK. Again, you can name this. I would like to name this sketch and then play with this setting. I would like to keep these both settings as they are. I would make the changes in the lower one in size. I will keep it at 3 and this setting to pressure variation. What value you keep here, you have to keep the same value here to get a perfect pressure sensitive brush. Okay, so I have pressed 3 and now you can hit OK. Now let's test the brush, how we have made this. Click the brush icon here from brush panel, from the tool panel. Okay, if I press harder, the stroke will be more. But if I press with a little lighter hand, then stroke will be small. So this is how the brush works. A pressure sensitive brush works like this. So let's make a sketch so that we can understand the process of how it works. So first step is going to be making a perfect sketch, and for that I'm going to use pen tool and my brush that I have made right now. Bring your photo in Illustrator, fit it in the canvas, and then lock the layer that the photo you have attached, and then make a new layer, make a sketch on that. Okay, so now I have worked it out and I have made my sketch ready, but you can see there are some extra lines. I have to cut that out. For cutting down extra lines, follow me. Select each and everything, go to object menu and select expand appearance and come here to pathfinder, click divide. In this way, all the lines that are above other will be cut. Now you have to take direct selection tool and select each of the lines that are extra and press delete key to delete them. You can delete more than one line in one time by pressing shift key and then selecting each layer that is extra and press delete key to delete all of the selected lines. Okay, so once all the extra lines are deleted, now we have to merge it. For merging, follow me again. Select each and everything, go to Pathfinder, and then click Merge. In this way, you can merge everything that you have drawn. All the sketch will be one. It will be considered just a one line. Once everything is merged, now we have to go to next step. And that is to fill. For filling the color, make the duplicate layer of the sketch layer and then lock the upper layer and keep the down layer unlocked. Now go to rectangle tool and then select rectangle and make a rectangle there, and after that fill a color that matches skin. Once you are satisfied with the color, right click and go to arrange menu and then send to back. In this way, the rectangle will be behind the lines, so our artwork will be in front of everything. Now select everything on the layer and go to object, expand, and then pathfinder. In pathfinder, select merge and right click, choose isolate selected group. Now select direct selection tool and click outside the line work and press delete key. Now you can select each part separately and color it on your choice. Make sure you have selected direct selection. Coloring, it's time for shading. For shading, I use only one tool, and that is pencil tool. For shading, there would be two types of colors. The first one will be a darker color than the skin. Whatever color you have kept for skin, that would be darker than that color. And then there would be a lighter color that would be used for highlights. And the darker color will be used for shadows. Shading layers will be between the color layer and the sketch layer. So shading layers will be in between them. Let me be clear, you cannot excel shading in one day. There would be so much time. You have to practice. You have to do a lot of practice, and finally one day you will achieve success. There are tons of methods of shading, but what I use is to be gradual. I go from less harder color first and then a little harder color than the first layer, and after that a little more harder layer than the second layer. So I just go gradual. There's no hard and fast rule for how much shading layers be. What personally I use is 3 to 4 shading layers. That works absolutely amazing for me. But of course, more layers will create more details. The more layers you bring in, there would be more details. For shading, you can follow the real picture. For highlights and shadows, wherever you see there are highlights, you have to paint highlights on the sketch. And if you see there are some shadows, then their shadows will highlight their highlight. But of course, that need a lot of practice again, I will say, to make the shading perfect. And if you want a separate video of how to shade, that would be available soon. Okay, so once our shadow layers are completed, we are going to make another layer for highlights. Personally, I use a trick. Make a full white color for highlights and then lessen down the opacity. In this way, I don't have to judge the colors. Are they matching skin or not? I don't have to be worried about that. I just lessen down the opacity of white color, and that works pretty well for me. Okay, so once our shading is done, now we are going to go to the next step, and that is the last one. Now we have to supply some of the details in hair, rather call it hair shading. For making details in hair, I use gradient and paint with brush. That's simple. For making a perfect gradient for hair, I use white in the middle and the color of hair on the sides. And if I want, I can lessen down the opacity to match with hair. This is the time for revealing the surprise, and that is this amazing kit that you can use to remember the whole process. You don't have to follow videos again and again, watch them again and again. Don't worry, you have this kit. Of course, if you have watched this video completely, this will be a complete guide of all the process that we have learned here. So you don't have to watch this video again and again. Just watch one time and use that kit. Make it work. This was it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this, and if you really did, give us a like and also subscribe to our channel. Ring that bell icon so that you don't miss any updates from us. I'll be seeing you with my latest content next time. Until then, I'll say you goodbye. Thank you. See you again.